Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Shanghai. We are here for the fourth race of the season in our little Lotus. We've managed to qualify in 14th, which is our best qualifying yet. Teammate is down at the back. I don't really care where he is. I out-qualified him. I'm pretty sure I out-qualified him. Obviously, there's only really going to be one way to find out. So, we are in the middle of the grid. We got Petrov and Kobayashi in front of us. Okay, that was a much better start than we've ever got before. We're on the inside of Petrov. Gonna hold that round the inside. Already up into 12th place. Gave him a little bit of a tap there, but he managed to hold it. And same to Sutil. Put the power down a bit too early in the wrong gear, but that's okay. We managed to hold it and we're up into 11th place, following the Force India. Schumacher locking up. Other than that, nice and clean through the first few corners, other than those few little taps here and there. Now, this is where the little car struggles, just because of, well, it's not a perfectly balanced car, and, well, long, fast corners it doesn't do well in. Which is pretty much what Shanghai is made up of. So, it's going to be an interesting one to see how the car handles it, but we should be fine. So still we've got the Force India of Sutil up in front of us. But I'm up in 11th place, which is absolutely ridiculous. I mean, we did have to, you know, pull something out of the bag after the last race. And I did do a hell of a lot more practice than usual. But yeah, we'll see what happens. Again, we got Schumacher sort of locking up, I believe. Now, I just need to focus and actually finish this race, because normally my problem is I fuck up. And if I don't fuck up, I might actually be able to get some points. And if I get some points, that will be good for my future. And we're going to just cut in on that. Okay, you're probably going to notice maybe a difference in the recording. For some reason, it was going below 30 FPS. And I just had a look, and for some reason, it was recording in the wrong format. And also, I was telling it to record at 30 FPS and not 60. So, I fixed that. Now we're at 60 FPS in 1080p, using the right format. And look at this, smooth! So, apologies for the first half of the video being a bit jumpy. Hopefully the rest of it won't be. So we're coming around here on the fast right-hander in Shanghai, which is probably the corner we don't struggle too much with because of the banking. Still in 11th place, coming on to the end of lap 2 now. Still got Sutil and Luisi behind us. Tyres are actually starting to dip off a bit, which is interesting because we've only really done 2 laps. Although we have also done quite a lot of qualifying laps on these tyres, so that will probably be explaining that one. Definitely sort of noticing the effect on them through the middle part of the corner. This car doesn't do well in fast corners, and any corner really, just because that's how it is, and that's kind of the effect we're having. I'm hoping I probably won't be pitting this lap, but the next lap I will be. That really was not my fault. There wasn't really much I could do. I don't think I got a penalty. I know. I'm good. And I'm in the points. Now, I don't expect to be in the points by the end of this. In fact, I don't even need to expect to be near the top 10. I'm just going to imagine falling back. Normally, I get screwed over in the pit stops or something like that. But we'll just have to wait and see what happens, really. Yep. Okay, so these tires have all obviously worn, and I really fucked that up and missed my braking point. Okay, and so that's my braking point missed. And that's me down into 12th. Luigi overtook me, and so did Kobayashi, but we got the slipstream on Kobayashi. I did kind of compromise him going into that corner, but that's okay, I've got the position back. So we're reaching about 2.25 plus. I've got to try and not look up. Now I'm hoping I'm pitting on the next lap, because I don't think many more laps like that can help. But the tyres really are affecting this. Obviously, the Lotuses, the HRTs, the lower sort of cars really require on mechanical grip. So as soon as the tyres start dropping off, it really is noticeable in these lower tier cars. At least that's how it is in real life. Obviously, the bigger teams have a lot more aero. So although they say, obviously, they still use the mechanical grip, they're not just going to disregard it, and they're still affected by it, but it just affects these smaller cars first. So my front left is really starting to drop off. I'm just going to have to take it a lot slower through these corners, which doesn't seem to be too much of a problem. I'm expecting a lot of the cars around me to have similar sort of issues. But as you can see, my tyres are fairly ruined. But on lap 4, pitting at the end of this, which is fantastic. Going to go on to the primes, and hopefully we'll just, even if we just maintain this position and get a single point, that would be pretty good for Lotus. And it would be pretty good for my 2011 season. It means I might actually get a contract offer from a decent, maybe even a higher team tier. I mean, to get a point in a Lotus is pretty damn good. But I'm just kind of looking for anything, even from the Force India. I mean, Force India is pretty competitive this year, so, you know. In hindsight, obviously, we know that next year, not that, you know, they don't really do that great. But still. Round the corner. Now, I need to remember to pit, because I never remember to pit. And it looks like Kobayashi is really struggling. This is... That pit lane. Okay. So I'm now going to get dumped down to the bottom of the field. And then I got to hope that I can actually move up and do something with these prime tyres. Obviously, we're going to have about a 6 second stop, I'd imagine. 4.2, same as every other one. I'm really hoping in 2015 they fix that. That's one of my real big issues. That wasn't my fault. You cannot... Don't give me a penalty. Oh. So the computer obviously controls you going out of the pits for the most part. And then obviously you take over. And obviously... Ooh, Hülkenberg going incredibly slowly. Not going to complain. That's another position for me.
We're 4 places above our expected end position.
So we're in 14th after the pit stops. Same with Al-Jaswari. Maybe these are the guys that haven't pitted, and look how it's affecting them. We're literally in a Caterham. We are catching them like we're in a McLaren. This race has actually might go in our favour. It looks like all the cars that haven't pitted yet, their tyres have basically obviously gone into that red stage where they have no grip and they're utterly useless. And obviously now I'm on the hards, I can go for the more longer stint. Keep that on the track. Oh, that was a close one. So we're up into 13th. We've got Luis in front of us. Obviously, he's the one that I don't think he's pitted yet. In fact, I don't think a lot of the ones in front of us have pitted, which is why they're in front. So it looks like we've got some nice open ground now. Is anyone in the pits? Anyone? No. No one! Okay, so there's all my theories just being smashed. All I can think of is the ones that haven't pitted it on primes. So they're going to be obviously going until the last 4 laps. And then hopefully And then obviously they're going to hope to actually overtake us all.
The tires are within the optimum temperature zone.
They might be, but the car's not exactly in the optimum range, is it? So lap 6, we're over halfway now. We just got to finish, I guess. This is the race we needed, though. We needed to do something a bit better than what we have been doing. Because what we have been doing has been utterly awful. But we're in for a pretty boring race, I reckon, from now until the end. Just because there's no one around us. I can't even get around that corner without running wide, and that was me going fairly slowly. So, although I did get the angles all wrong. Now down onto the back easy straight, where we can kind of take a minute to think about how things are going. But it looks like someone's in front of us. Louise is in front of us, not too far ahead. And locked up. That's not going to help our battle. But that's okay. Now, has he pitted or is he still going? I can't see him. No. No. There he is. So my teammate is now down in 21st. Haha. I believe in the last race he finished quite high while I didn't finish. Obviously we had that puncture and everything went tits up. So this race is going more in our favour now. To be honest, I can't remember if we got any points in the last race, but I'm hoping there's a chance I will get some in this one, because that would really help our battle. And okay, I'm probably going to be actually too far behind anyway to make any difference. Ooh, someone's crashed. Maybe that's why the Ferrari's coming in then. Come on, little car. Okay, that was not a good corner. Is that a car? Oh, there's a car going really slow. Looks like it was a Marussia. Okay, he was blue flagged though. So we have a blue flagged Marussia effectively stopping on the back straight on the racing line. That's not going to help the proceedings of the race. No one's in the pit. Someone's just come out. I'm going to... So that's not really going to affect us in any way. I'm about to come up behind my teammate. So that's kind of summing up how this race is going. Still in 13th place. Whoa, he's going ridiculously slow as well. Must be something about the blue flags. Got caution again. No, we're okay. That could have been from Truly, because he was going incredibly slowly. I don't think we're going to catch Kobayashi in the Sauber. Not if he's probably on options. But, you know. Your brakes are at optimum operating temperature.
There's been a crash in Sector 3. Yellow flag.
Ooh, there's been a big crash in Sector 3. Ooh, this is good, this is good. I mean, oh, I hope they're okay. Not really. Well, I do, but... Come on. That was awful. There was about three or four cars just sort of stopped looking at the minimap. I mean, that's... just another stupid Marussia stopping. And I really miss my breaking point, guys. Oh, that's really not good. Okay, we're back on.
Sector 1 is showing a green flag. Racing conditions through Sector 1.
No one's in the pits, but we're in 13th. So we just kind of got to carry on. I think we might have some more back markers up ahead. Either that or Kobayashi has caught up with the other two cars. Yeah, we got a back marker of Senna going ridiculously slowly as usual. And that's now lap 9 starting. So we've still got Kobayashi in front of us. It kind of looked like Mercedes, which is why I was going to sort of say, oh, look, it looks like we've got Schumacher or someone. But it's not. It's still Kobayashi. Tyres are holding up fairly well, both thermally and in just normal tyre degradation. That is a tough word. Tyre wear. Much better. Much more suited. So I think there's only the one of them. Yeah, there's still only Kobayashi. But the okay, so we got another yellow flag. Okay. And we're going down the back straight for the 9th time or 10th time. Don't even know. Make sure I don't miss my braking point this time. So we had the waved yellows, didn't see any debris or anything, so I'm guessing there wasn't any. Either that or it was cleared up. Again, still in 13th as we go on to lap 10 of the Chinese Grand Prix. I think we might be slightly catching Kobayashi, but I wouldn't sort of expect on overtaking him and getting 12. I would like to have got some points, but we're in a Lotus. And obviously, I think our tyres are starting to show somewhere. Other than that,
is it optimal temperature?
Let's just... So Kobayashi is a little bit slower than me, I believe. If I looked at that correctly. Not by much, you know, but enough.
There's been a crash in sector 3.
Again. Ooh, that's the Marussia again. Oh. And I put the car in neutral? How did I put the car in neutral? But I'm hoping that Senna's really kind of compromised Kobayashi down here. We might even get 12th place. That would be really nice. So we're just going to sit in his slipstream. No overtaking. No overtaking. Did kind of push Kobayashi round, but that's okay. So there's 12th place. Oh, he's on the options. So obviously he's done the opposite stint of doing prime than option, and it's not actually paid off because now his options have dropped off and he's useless. Not even defendable against a Lotus. And we're on our last lap. I mean, obviously he can probably catch us fairly easily, I'm not saying that, but round the corners, I'm guessing that I have the upper hand. So now we're in 12. We were close to the points finish. Not this time. But this kind of just... There's a bit of hope. Bit of hope for some points. Also, it means I finally get a good finish, which I really needed. Been a bit more of an eventful race. Lots of yellow flags. Lots of slow-moving AI. But I'm sure it's just the track configuration with the mods and things. Mark Webber has won the Chinese Grand Prix. Good for him. Doesn't happen too often. And we come around the nice sweeping banked right-hand corner. Onto the back foam straight for the final time. It's been a lovely race day here. Ooh, there's a bloody... Marussia still, or Virgin, as they were called back now, here, then, 2010. Yeah, Kobayashi is not going to be posing a threat unless, obviously, I fuck this corner up. I almost fucked that corner up and almost got a penalty. But that has been our Chinese race. We finished 12th, we started in 14th, so we've gained positions as well. I didn't even think about that. So I believe we've we outraced him and we outqualified our teammate. In first place, obviously, was Weber, Massa, Rosberg, Vettel. Who was down at the bottom? Buemi, Barrichello, Sutil. Okay, so we got two disqualifieds, two DNFs. That has been our Chinese Grand Prix race. So these are the standings. I'm now up in 17th. Huge lead over my teammate who's... No, I was thinking Degrassi was my teammate. It's not, it's Trulli. Is it Trulli? No, who's my teammate? Oh, that's embarrassing. Luisi. No, it is Trulli. Oh my God, Luisi and Trulli. Right, they're the standings. Mark Webber is leading, followed by Rosberg, but then we've got Jenson Button and Lewis Hamilton following up in third and fourth. That's about it, really. Constructors, we're still down in 11th, I don't really think. I mean, Virgin, look at that. They got a point in one of the races. Bloody hell. So, obviously, we're going to have to hopefully get a point, maybe one or two, and that will just push us up the standings. God, I forgot how to talk then. So, really, until next time, guys, thank you for watching, and I will, see you next time. Take care.